So we're here with Alana Katz, a registered sports dietitian. Thanks for joining us. This is a very important part of training for a triathlon, as you know. So I wanted to go through a couple of the food diaries, and specifically with Ray and Annette. Talk about the value and importance of smaller meals throughout the day.
What we found on Annette and Ray's food diaries is that you guys are waiting a long time before you eat. What small meals more often does during the day is prevents us from going between grazing and starving. And remember, it's the grazing, starving, like cows eat, which causes us to store fat.
The prevailing wisdom is, I'm just gonna eat less, that's gonna help me lose weight.
Right, and that doesn't work, eating less to lose weight, because if the body's starving, it holds on, even if you're eating really good food. So eating less, more often, is much better. I actually call it Elmo's law. Eat less, more often. Elmo.
Let's talk about Doug for a second. It jumps right out that about 6 a.m. you'll have soda, and then sometimes throughout the morning, that's sort of your drink. Alana, let me ask you, I mean, sugary drinks, obviously a lot of people have them. Some people start their day with them. As a registered sports dietitian, what do you tell your clients?
Doug. In fact, on your sports logs, on your logs, I wrote oi, because all your nutrients are coming from sugar.
Where does that come from for you, Doug? How come so much of the soda first thing in the morning?
Probably lack of planning.
Yeah.
Just easy to grab?
Yeah, I get up at 5 in the morning, and usually I work by 6:30, and it's just grab it out of the refrigerator and go. And because I haven't been planned days in advance or the night before, it's too late by the time that happens.
Speaking of which, Will, I can relate to some of what you do, because I didn't learn how to cook when I was younger, but you eat out a lot. Talk about some of the reasons why that is the case for you, but you saw Will's food diary. What first jumped out at you?
All your food's coming from restaurant food, a lot of fast food, and it tells me lack of planning.
And again, from a sports dietitian standpoint, if he's got a little bit of time on the weekend to cook for the week, what should he be focused on?
Focusing on foods that you can separate into containers, make your own lean cuisines. Personally, I make a big pot of quinoa, and then I can eat off of it during the week. I just add things to it, like pumpkin seeds and almonds. I make a big pot of chili, and I freeze most of it. Good lean turkey, lots of veggies. I even throw baked potatoes in the microwave and have it with Greek yogurt, like sour cream on top.
I think that's a good segue to maybe we should all go navigate the supermarket now, figure out where we should be spending our time and our money.
How many of you have tried kale before? For breakfast, you can put it in your smoothies. For lunch, you can even make a salad out of it. And for dinner, you could saute it or bake it. So this is our seafood section. One thing to keep in mind is that if you see something that has bones and skin on it, if you go to the grocery store, they will take the skin off and take the bones out for you. So don't be afraid or intimidated to ask about that.
The leaner the meat is, the less white stuff you're gonna see. So you can tell the higher fats of meat are gonna be like your ribs and your brisket, whereas your tenderloins, your loins, and your ground round are the leanest cuts.